Hi, welcome. It's Torin Atkinson. It's time for 20 Minute Monsters. I do this in a live stream on my Twitch channel, twitch.tv/Torin Atkinson. Sorry, just cleaning my glasses here so I can see what I'm doing. Every week, I take a creature from the 1980 or something Fiend Folio from Advanced Dungeons and Dragons, and I draw a monster. This, what you're looking at now, is a little clue as to what today's monster is going to be. Well, let's get rid of that. Oink. All right, so here we go. Hey, check out my art. I've got art for sale. And what's coming up? Christmas or holidays. If your holiday of choice involves giving gifts to your loved ones, hey, maybe your loved one would like some original Dungeons & Dragons or Call of Cthulhu pencil artwork. And you can find that on torinatkinson.com. Artwork, original art for sale. Okay. If you like what I do, there's always Patreon. Patreon, my friends. I'm going to say it every single time. And, find me on Instagram for more crazy weirdness. So today, get rid of that, is the letter E. Last week we did D for Darkstalker. Today we're doing E for Ettercap. If we have time, I might. I got a lot of requests for Ettercap, and I got a lot of requests for Eye of Fear and Flame. I wanted to do two of them this morning. We'll see if we have time. So what can we see about the Ettercap? I think this is a Russ Nicholson drawing from the Fiend Folio. Number appearing 1 to 2. That's not very many. They've got poison. They've got special defenses, traps, see below. Their intelligence is low. Interesting. And they are neutral evil. And their size medium. A biped, roughly man-sized. I'm going to turn down my volume a bit. It's distracting me. Okay. As we listen to Big Spider Becky. I don't know how to pronounce his last name. A biped, roughly man-sized, with very long arms, protruding pot belly, short legs, and hairy skin. The Ettercap has clawed hands and two poison fangs protruding one from each side of the mouth. Ettercaps are cruel, cunning, despite their low intelligence, and treacherous. The Ettercap attacks with the claws and inflicts a poisonous bite. The creature has silk glands like those of a spider located near the anus. Yes. These glands secrete a thin, very tough, silvery cord, which the beast uses to make assorted weapons and devices. Lariats, nets, garrots, tripwires, and so forth. Each Ettercap has its preferred weapons and trap devices, so an encounter will vary according to an Ettercap's preference. They will always lay traps and prepare an ambush if there is time to do so. They get along well with all forms of spider. In the chat today, Charles Smith Org, welcome back in the old Twitch stream live chat. So that's the entry straight out of the Fiend Folio. Let's take a look at, as I like to do, this is Tony DiGiulizzi's second edition, I want to say. Friend, Ettercap, looks a bit different. Still looks very humanoid. They get, as the editions advance, they get more spider-like, more bug-like. This is, I think this is also second edition. Maybe it's the Monstrous Compendium or something. I have this down as M. Kaluta, which I think is what I'm looking at here. This is obviously more spidery, but still very humanoid-y, fleshy, mammal-y anatomy in the arms and legs. And he's just gonna look at that belly. So we're gonna do... So I thought this good guy might be, the Ettercap might be enticing an elf with an, let me get a nice green here. With an emerald. With an enormous emerald. So, yeah. Let me make sure I got my correct brush here. Which one was I using last time? My layer. This is just regular. We don't want that. We want to go down to... What was I... I was doing like a... Watery? Was I doing the watery? I was doing bleedy. I might have been doing bleedy. I I remember it had... No, I wasn't doing bleedy, because it had some translucence to it. So maybe it must have been watery. Let's do watery. Okay. Alright, so this is... an emerald. An Ettercap. I'm using green for emerald. And we'll see. Now, I had a vision as I was lying in bed. I was like, what is he going to be doing? Is he going to be eating elf entrails? No, that's too gory. That's gonna, when I do my... I always post these to various Facebook groups, D&D and ARC Facebook groups, and some of them have rules about gore and nudity. So I don't want to get too extreme. Extreme also starts with E. I wanted to do it in an entrance. So let me just give you... This is not the drawing. We're not drawing yet. But I wanted to have him, the elf, coming out of the entrance, and the Ettercap, like, nice and big in the foreground, so you could really see the Ettercap. Because I also thought about, well, what if you see the elf close up reaching for the emerald? Here's the emerald. Reach. And then the emerald... the Ettercap was like lurking, ready to strike. But that puts the Ettercap in the background. And the Ettercap is supposed to be the star. So I thought, what kind of entrance would I do? Like, I know from playing D&D, Baldur's Gate and other video games, they're usually in the woods. But I didn't want to put this guy. I wanted to have an entrance. So I thought, I'll do my little trick that I like to do. Let me show you. And I go to Sketchfab. I typed in entrance, as you can see, and then I found, oh, this is a nice D&D type model, and then I just, which I can screw around with whatever angle I want, and I can use this as a reference. So I decided to do something like, he's coming out, you can see him, the elf down here in the right hand corner, and then the Ettercap would be here, and the emerald would be hanging down. Problem is these pillars, so you gotta get the right angle. And I get rid of this. That's a little trick. That's a little artist trick. If you don't have time to go out and take photos from the exact angle you want. So I just grabbed. I did a screen grab here, and we can just ever so quickly. All right, it's 10:10. That gives us until 10:30 exactly. We're gonna start. So I'm just going to. Quickly draw just so I have the planes correct, and that's that. Okay, like maybe I'll put this off in over in the corners for so I can keep it as reference. So that's our... I'm not sure if I'm going to put the... okay, what's going on? Oh, it's because I have that selected. I'm not sure if I'm going to put the... let's hide that. There's that little iron part on the front, at the top here. I'm not sure if I'm going to put that on, because first I need to draw mine. So I want it to be hanging. So our guy's going to be here. The elf is going to be stepping out. He's going to be reaching up to the emerald. Our emerald's going to be hanging. Let's draw that. That's the web. And it's going to be a big, multifaceted emerald. Does that look like an emerald? Not really. I feel like if I'm going to sell emerald, I've got to draw it to make it look like an emerald. Okay. Add some shine to that at the end. It's just hanging from a thread, from a literal thread. Something like that. And then we got our elf du jour, always going to be Rudiger the elf. He's like, oh, hey, what's this? Maybe I will have space for that thing above. I can put some extra cobwebs there. Things. Oh, hello. Hands. Draws. Torso, shoulders. Ears. Eye will be somewhere. Oh, he's excited. He's excited about that. Oh, hello. Oh, I've been having this. Yeah, that's been popping up. And then sometimes my... Let's save it, because sometimes it just crashes. And it hasn't crashed, luckily, during a stream. So that's good. Alright, so that's our general shape for Rudiger the Elf. I feel like his arm should be more straight. Less bendy, I don't know. It's very cartoony, but you get the idea. He's got his elvish bracers on, of course. Which has the straps or whatever. We don't want to get too concerned. Like I say, Rudiger is not the star of the show. I've been ignoring the chat. Is anyone here saying things? Nobody knew. Oh, there we go. It crashed. That sucks. Okay. If I just open up Photoshop, will it just restore what I did? Yeah, that really sucks. I need to figure out what's going on. Open recent? Nope. Ettercap? Ba-da. Yeah, I lost some work. That sucks. Just as I was saving it. God damn it. Alright, well. We do what we can. Technology. Some technical difficulties. If it happens again. Oh, see, now I don't even have the right color selected. This is really annoying. And do I have... No, and that's not even the right... I want... Watery nib. Watery nib. Where are you? I have too many... Bleed. Ultra bleed? Fountain inker. Is that the one? Let's just do that one. Alright, I'm gonna save. I don't know what last time it did it. It gave me a restored version. But not this time. So that sucks. Gives me a chance to do a better job of drawing, though. Leg. What's going on with that leg? Never mind. It's too... Yeah, no. Nah. Something more like that. Like, am I gonna... What's the quick save? Do I just hit... Control S will save. All right. Control S. We'll have to do that constantly then to avoid having to redraw things. No, that leg sucks. Straight down. Straight down. There we go. That's what we want. And then this can be coming out. And there's... Yeah. Okay. So, great. Let's get to our Ettercap, the star of the show. Oh, hello. What's going on there? Control S. And the Ettercap. Let me look at my thing again. So there's two pillars. This pillar... right up here, and I should have taken a closer note of the digital resurrection spell. Charles Smith Org, thank you for joining me this morning, by the way. Let me see how... sorry, I'm just adjusting my thingy thing. Okay, I drew that in the wrong layer. Come back to that. X. V. That's fine. We'll merge these layers later. Right now we're drawing. We're drawing. God damn it. So there's the pillar in the back. That's all fine and dandy. Oh, okay, we'll merge these now, actually. What's going on out there in the world? Charles Smith Org. What's new and exciting? So that's the one pillar. Man died. Oh, snap. I'm trying to get the perspective right here. That's not quite right. Yeah, because that should go all the way down. We might not actually see that. We may not have space for that, but that's fine. Okay, and then this pillar. Must feel like it should be bigger, but whatever. Whatever. Let's put that. Let's go ahead and put that there. Don't want to spend too much on this. It's not the point. Not going to worry about that. Let's draw our Ettercap. What does an Ettercap look like? Let me take a look again. Oh, let me save my work. I'm going to do my own take on it. That's for sure. Oops. God damn it. It's not going to look like this. As much as I like the old Fiend Folio, this is kind of a dull... Not dull, but I would say uninspired. Whereas this is kind of more my speed. And where's the Ditcher Lizzie one? Did I delete it? No, here it is. And that's fun too. Control T? Control T? No? Why aren't you? You don't want a Control T? There we go. There's my stars, my three stars. Let's put them all in one layer. Make it yellow. Save my work. All right. He's going to be, obviously, he's going to be looking. I want to make him kind of upside down-ish, I guess. Let me get rid of this. How do we do this? This is the tricky part. I'm halfway through. It's 10:20. I've got 10 more minutes. Oh, hello. I like the claws. They're supposed to have really long arms. Like, almost like, you know how Spider-Man? I've been drawing a lot of Spider-Man lately, so. Let me look at that big thing that I had. That was a jumping spider. Okay, let's get rid of that. Something like that? Basically a spider. No, I don't want him to have a spider head. Exactly. I want him to have... He doesn't need to have eight eyes. But I do want him to have big. And big old fangs. I think he's... Ugh, not sure about this. Where's his other arm? Like here, I guess? Come on. I didn't give him enough room. Maybe I just need to make him smaller. You know what? I think I might have to make him a bit smaller. At least his head. Because I want his arm. Okay, so this is like, we're looking at his back. This is his spine. If he were a humanoid. But I also want him to be twisting. Stubby legs. Right. So then his other shoulder would be here, which is fine. He's not on this pillar. This pillar is farther away. He's on the closer pillar. Can we say that? I think we can say that. That doesn't work. There's another pillar here. Don't want it to interfere with the string hanging down. And some webbing here. Some webbing here. And I want to give him a little spider buddy. Let's see how we can do it. Let's give him some bit of oval eyes. Oval eyes. Control save. Control S. Maybe I'll just do that. That's fang-like. Okay. Let me take a look at my references again. Head shape. The first two have ears. Should I give them ears? Seems weird to give a spider guy ears, but let's do it. He is a monster after all. And then hair. But before we get into the hair and shit, maybe the other spider friend is over here. Not blocking his anatomy. Oh god. It's not interacting properly with the architecture here. As we call it in the industry, geo. That's a little better. Then I can put the... can make him look more like he's on this pillar. Pella. Right? Oh my god, we're at 10:24. I gotta hurry my ass up. Okay. Maybe he will be grabbing onto the further away pillar with that arm, but not with this arm. Okay. All right. I think we're getting somewhere. He's supposed to have a big pot belly, but I can't draw his back and his front at the same time. That's just... it's just weird. Let's see. Doesn't really help, does it? Let's zoom out. Where can I put his legs? This leg is definitely going to be here. Maybe he would just show his other leg here. So this is his back here. He's not as forward towards the camera as I wanted him to be. And that's fine. And then I will have room to put his little jumping spider buddy there, assuming I have time to draw that. So he's on... oh. This is hard. Maybe his knee is here. And I just... We just don't worry about... There's more columns on this side. We're gonna pretend. We're gonna use our imaginations here. Because I don't have time to rework this. Alright, so... let's get a little darker. Let me save. And then let's finish up. We're running low on time. Since this is opaque, I can kind of like... that doesn't look good, though. I think they should be... let me look at my spider reference. Like, that's so interesting, isn't it? Isn't it? It's very interesting. Is it? I mean, will it work? It just looks like big cartoon eyes. So maybe I just... god damn it. Maybe I just make them big black eyes. Let's get rid of these lines. And the center line for his head. Get some of those hairs. Bulbous. Maybe he just has one little extra eye. And then we do his things. Now, should they be this way? Or should they be more straight down? I think that's fine. Nice and dark, coated in venom. Dripping venom. Should be more that way. All right. And then save our work. Damn you, snow. And long. Give him some joints. Why not? And maybe nice long claws. How many claws should he have? I think two is fine. I don't have time to draw a third claw. My god. More joints. Unnecessary joints. Okay. Not sure about this pen. This brush that I chose. Where, oh my god, I got 2 minutes left. Like maybe he's like, he's not, I don't know, is he holding on to this one? Sure. Spider-Man! Some hairs there. We need some hairs on this side as well. Creepy hairs. And then, oh, that's his leg. Don't erase his leg. How is his back gonna... Spikes are cool, right? And then, my god, it's so messy. This is his other leg. This is his knee. Hopefully this can make this out. Get some roly-polies in there. That's so many lines. So many scribbly lines. And I still have to do my... his little buddy. Oh, that's his shoulder. Okay. It's fine. It's foreshortened. Don't worry about it. Don't overthink it. Almost done. We're at time, but I'm not finished yet, so. We're going over time with this one, folks. Maybe I'll like... You don't really get the sense of the potbelliness, but... What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? I just feel like he needs... Maybe he does need those... Let me bring those ears back. Where are they? Where were they? Where's a good place for these ears? I mean, ears traditionally are on the side of the head. So let's not screw with tradition. I kind of want them to be almost antenna... More antennas than ears, but... And then let's get them some hairs. Ettercap was a little tougher than I thought it was going to be. And, leg. Gotta draw through. Let me zoom in. We're zooming in. Is this leg? Where does it go? It goes down. It should be more like... This one, he's got multiple. He doesn't just have two, he has multiple. You know what I'm saying? To grab onto the... Getting a little tangent happening there, so that's no good. Get those hairs. Need some more hairs on his back, too. Something like that. This is his other leg. I really... kind of screwed the pooch on this one, but that's fine. People are going to say, what is going on with this guy's anatomy? And that's what happens when you put him in a weird position. All right, so this is our... That's our Ettercap. I might put on his little friend later on, but for now, let's just... not worry about it. Let's finish. Not Edgar. Rudiger. Edgar the elf. Let's get that. This is the rest of the column here. Marble column. You gotta get yourself a marble column. Is that making it better or making it worse? I feel like it's making it worse, but... some cracks. Weathering. Fregretto lines, as I like to call them. And these just... just... may I just suggested... just a suggested... All right, Rudiger. Ooh. Big eyes. Ooh. Bit of a... First I drew him in profile, and now I'm adding... He's excited. He's excited. Give him his little... his elf mullet, as I like to call it. Let's get that elf ear in there. And, yeah. It's definitely taking longer than 20 minutes. That much we are certain of. So, I've forgotten what his cuirass looks like. Let's give him his belt, his sword. I don't care if he's lefty or righty at this point, I've just got to get him done. Belt. Zoom out. His head's really big, but oh well. Let's fix this hand a little bit. Ooh, gimme. Gimme. That's fine. Something like that. Elven foot. A good old elven foot. Alright. Pretty damn close to, supposed to be pointing at the top, as I recall. But. We're not worried. Okay! Is anybody still here in the chat? Let me check. Doesn't Photoshop have an autosave? It does, and you know what? I should turn that on. Great suggestion. Okay. All right, this is it. We're done. I wish I had time to add in his little... You know what? I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. We're going to put in a little guy. Let me... just and then there's the shadow nose and an emerald gleam. we might do a white layer over top of this. Let's see if we have how I feel. All right, I had some pictures of jumping spiders, so let's add in a little jumping spider here. He's also... they have more eyes. I don't want to make him straight on though. One, two, three. I get some... need more room. Petty Palps. And then... Oh my god. Legs. They have legs. I'm pretty sure spiders have legs. Draw those legs. Let's get rid of these. This one over here. Like, I have one reference up. And then... They're friendly, right? Jumping spiders. Oh god, I forgot how to draw. Whatever. And the last one over here. Alright, we did it. The other thing I like, which I don't have time for, but looking at these references, I really like all the spots that Ditter Lizzie put on his. I don't think that's going to help my drawing by adding more distracting lines. So, we'll just save. And we will, let's quickly, ever so quickly, add some... A little glint in his eye. And some glints on the appropriate... kind of didn't finish his arm over there. Get this guy here. Accentuate that he's actually got. And we can put some. Not too many. Too many is bad. But, we can just. I feel like I'm putting on too many. Let's get that. Okay. And then just one here. And one here. And one here. Okay. This is. Oh shit. Let's put this on a separate layer. I'm in a bit of a rush today because we have to take our tires changed over the winter tires. Is this a new layer? Yes, great. Ettercap. 20 minute monster. Twitch. TV. I started doing this. Torrent Atkinson. I think it's a good idea. 2023. All right. You saw it. You came. You saw it. I hope you had a good time. Maybe I'll do Eye of Fear and Flame some other time. Because there was quite a lot of requests for that. Let me reset my view. Let's zoom out a little bit. I can see that I need to scooch my design over a bit so it's more centered. And that's it. Let me check the chat. Love it when evil is so cute. Thank you, Charles Smith, Org, and whoever the second viewer is who hasn't said anything in the chat. That's fine. You don't have to. No pressure. But next week is going to be... What comes after E? F. And our options are... Let's make this full screen. Fire Drake. Fire Newt. Fire Snake. Fire Toad. Flail Snail. I'm definitely leaning towards Flail Snail because of rhyming. Flind. Always a good choice. Flump. Everyone loves Flump. For Lara, I actually have no idea what that is. And Frost Man. So come to my social medias. Find me on Facebook, find me on, I'm not really on Twitter. I am on Mastodon, and what's the other one? What's the other one? Hang on. It's, Blue Sky. I'm on Blue Sky and Mastodon, and of course, Instagram, and, if you have a strong, if you prefer, I feel like the choices are Flail Snail and Flump, so if you have an opinion about what I draw next week, please do come and express that opinion. And I will see you. I will say thank you one last time. And I'll say I see you on the internet. Bye-bye. Like and subscribe!